sticking around, guys. Appreciate it. Well, you know, let me just start out by saying I'm really proud of our team for the way that we came out and competed tonight against a very tough Indiana team that's playing great basketball right now. I thought, you know, besides the start where, you know, they jumped us early, we continued to fight and stay together. And, you know, I thought played extremely hard and with unbelievable effort. And went out there and made the right play, you know, especially offensively. That ball was flying around. We had great ball movement, great player movement. We were back cutting when they got out and pressured us. You know, guys were playing for each other for the entire 45 minutes tonight. You know, the difference was, you know, the size and strength of Indiana's front line. And, you know, in the paint, you know, we tried to do everything we could to stay in front, keep them out of it, you know, to help on the backside and then try to get try to find a way to secure the rebound. We had some good defensive possessions where we just could not dig out the tough rebound. And that's what they do. That's Indiana's game. They try to beat you up, make it a brawl, get to the free throw line, 38 free throws, 19 offensive rebounds. That's the difference. But, you know, like I told the guys in the locker room, it's very disappointing in there. They're disappointed. But if we go out and play with that kind of effort, we're going to have a chance to win a lot of games this year.
Fred, despite the fact that you lost, how would you rate this game compared to your other games you played? Is this one of your better games?
Well, it's certainly better than the last game. That was, you know, something that, you know, we made a concerted effort with, you know, a really lengthy film session on why what happened last Saturday happened. And, you know, it started with not getting back in transition and turning the ball over and had very poor offensive possessions and shot selection. And that's what allowed Craig to get confident and get downhill. You know, tonight I thought, you know, we came out and did everything that we've been preaching for the last couple of days in practice and film and carried that over onto the floor with again, a great effort to come out here in a hostile environment on the road. We did not handle that the first time we had the opportunity as a group to go out there. I thought we grew in a big way as a team tonight, and that's what it's all about for our team, is continue to take steps in the right direction, put ourselves in position to win. I thought our guys executed last play to get Deshaun Burke the ball, and he stepped up and made a huge shot. And then unfortunately they got off to the start and hit some clutch shots. That Finnessy hit with Cam Mack draped all over him was a huge possession of the game. We missed a couple chippies. That happens. You know, you got to find a way to get past it. But, you know, we were getting the ball where we wanted to tonight, where we needed to get it. And, you know, for the most part, converted. Unfortunately, we didn't do it late.
You mentioned that kind of slow start down 11-2. What started clicking for you guys to kind of get back in?
Well, we started in transition. You know, Burke got ahead of the defense and got an and-one, you know, to cut it to a six-point game. And then our pace really picked up. Did a good job, I thought, rebounding. We started getting back in transition. They had too many paint scores early. We limited that as the half went on and climbed back into the game. And, you know, again, I give our guys credit for going out there and continuing to trust each other, trust the system to get the ball movement where it needed to be. And, you know, again, we gave ourselves an opportunity to win a game shorthanded against a really quality opponent.
For you personally, you know, going from college to the NBA, back to college, what did you learn most of the time in Chicago? And then how was it kind of, you know, adjusted the way you kind of come back to coaching at the college?
Yeah, I mean, you know, every step I've had, I've really enjoyed, and, you know, my coaching journey. You know, starting with you know, having the opportunity to coach my alma mater was, you know, five great years, five unforgettable years, you know, to get a lot of really good things accomplished, and, you know, proud of what we did there. And, you know, this had the opportunity to jump up to the next level where, you know, I spent 10 years as a player, 5 years at front office, you know, to get up, you know, coach one of the great franchises in this game. And, you know, you learn a lot when you have opportunities to do that. You try to, you know, take everything from all the situations, good and bad, and, you know, we had some of both in the 3.5 years in Chicago, and then you try to apply it to the next situation you have and learn from some of the things that you know you could have done better. You know, I know this, I'm a better coach, you know, from being in the NBA, you know, for 3.5 years. You know, love the situation that we're in right now, Nebraska. You know, I feel really good moving forward. We've got, you know, some really good pieces, I think, that are on this group, and we've got three really good players sitting out. And on top of that, we're going to get a good recruiting class coming in next year or so. You know, it's similar to the way we built it.
Obviously, this was your guys' first Big Ten game. And from what we've seen just from this game, and then I'm sure you've been paying attention to the other games that have been going on, what's the biggest difference from the Big Ten to the Big 12 that you've seen?
Well, they're both great leagues. You know, different styles, but, you know, unbelievable leagues. You know, the Big Ten this year, every time you turn the TV on, you know, it's a competitive game, it's a battle, it's a war. You know, the teams are, you know, going in there. There's been a lot of upsets early, especially when, you know, these higher ranked teams have been going on the road. So yeah, it's you know, the 20 league games. It's, you know, it's tough. It's going to be a battle every time we go out there and play. We just need to compete. Again, if we go out and do what we did tonight, we're going to have a chance.
You mentioned Ross Finney's shot at the end there with that three pointer. I mean, what did you? Were you impressed by kind of the poise he showed?
Yeah, he's you can see he's kind of the heart and soul of this thing with that team, with his poise and the way he plays, and you know, to have the patience to, you know, get that thing down to one on the shot fake and, you know, rise up and knock it down. That's just a big time shot. But, you know, his ability to guard, you know, his ability to make the right play, you know, getting him back in the lineup was huge for Indiana. And, you know, as long as he's in there running the show, you know, they got bright days ahead. Thanks, guys.